1999. Here's to a happy new year from Stater Brothers Markets.
Right,
at In and Out, our hamburgers are made with the highest quality ingredients, made fresh and by hand, made with a smile, and made to order, just for you.
Just
before you purchase your new automobile this holiday season. For official rules and more information,
contact
on this station.
Go to KFIAM640.com.
Any word.
This is for non-violent offenders, but in fact it will apply to people convicted of certain things. Like domestic violence, human trafficking, possession of weapons by inmates who have previous violent felonies. So this is a debate about what is violent and what is not violent. Will never be settled. But anyway, a Sacramento judge said, yeah, we will do a restraining order for now while this legal argument makes its way through the legal process. President Biden and Vladimir Putin are going to chat, and they're going to talk about the troop buildup near Ukraine. This is their second call, and Putin's got about 120,000 troops there, so the it's probably not going to be a friendly conversation. But interestingly, Putin requested the call. Oh, well, we don't know what his agenda is yet.
Right.
But his agenda is to amass troops. But that's about it right now. I hate to say what I'm about to say, but I'm going to say it because it's true. In a battle of the wits, and I'm talking not just intelligence, I'm talking deviousness, I'm talking being able to play 3-4 steps ahead.
Mm-hmm.
Putin's got it all over the current president.
Oh, yeah.
And I think he had it all over the previous president as well.
Well, that's always... His M.O. is to be very calculated.
Yeah. I'm scared of that guy. That guy's scary.
So,
he is, and he weighs things like, okay, economic sanctions? Maybe we can deal with them. You know? Other things as well. But, yeah, that guy's kind of a scary guy.
Well, it'll be interesting to see the two narratives after it's done.
Oh, yeah.
You know, what does Russia say happened on the call, and what does it mean, and what does the United States say? Because I bet you they'll be different.
Sure.
Well, unlike New York, which scaled back their Times Square New Year's Eve celebration, not eliminating it completely, but scaling it back, Las Vegas is just going to do what they're going to do. Okay. They're expecting 300,000 visitors in town for New Year's Eve fireworks show. There's fireworks on the strip. There's a big concert downtown. And they're just saying, hey, here's what we're doing. We're telling you, if you're sick, don't come. And if you're inside, put a mask on. And that's about how we're going
to
handle it.
That's about it. They're telling people you're going to have to be responsible. And we know how that works.
Yes, be responsible. Las Vegas.
Yes.
Why do those two things not seem to go together very well?
And alcohol. JetBlue is cutting more than 1,280 flights from its schedule today through mid-January because of the fear of COVID-19 infections among pilots and flight attendants. So they're apparently predicting they're not going to have enough people to fly or serve.
I imagine it's going to get worse before it gets better.
Hey, Anthony Fauci said that,
too. All it takes is for you to get a sniffle. And I'm not being pejorative about it.
No.
I'm saying all it takes is for you to get a sniffle or maybe a little and you call in sick, and you sort of have to.
That's the rule around here. We've got people who say, these are allergies. I'm like, not until you get a COVID-19 test.
Yeah.
Then you can call them allergies.
Okay, speaking of COVID and airlines, a school teacher from Michigan isolated herself in the lavatory on a flight to Iceland because she tested positive for COVID-19 in the middle of the flight. She started to get a sore throat in the middle of this flight. She had with her a rapid test. She took it. It said, you have COVID. He said, oh my goodness. She was in the bathroom doing the test. And then she said, I'm not coming out of this bathroom. And there was a flight attendant who apparently became her guardian and savior, bringing her, you know, she needed water, bringing her stuff in there. And she just stayed in the bathroom for 5 hours. And then after, apparently the relationship continued. Because the flight attendant followed up because as soon as she landed in Iceland, she had to quarantine in a hotel. And the flight attendant brought flowers and some little Christmas tree that you could hang up. That part of it's kind of sweet.
It is kind of sweet. Here's something that isn't kind of sweet. You would think this would not happen. A woman in Valinda, I guess she forgot her keys or something, so she crawled in the window to her backyard into her house. And she was attacked by her dogs, 4 dogs, and she was killed.
Yeah, they were not as familiar with her as the other people who lived in the house, and so they didn't realize, oh, this is a person who's supposed to be here. This is an intruder.
I always thought dogs had this, like, keen sense of smell. If they sniff you once, they know who you are. If you've been around, in their area, in their territory, they would say, oh, yeah, I recognize that smell.
I think they usually do. You'll see videos, heartwarming videos on YouTube. There's one where a guy lost a bunch of weight. Like, he was maybe 300 pounds, and now he's 180 pounds. And his dog didn't recognize him and was like, who are you? Until got a whiff of him. And the second the dog got a whiff of him, boom, you're my guy. And it was great. And there's another video. It's a blind dog who obviously recognizes his person by smell. And they have these videos of when, let's say, the dog's in the yard hanging out and the person comes out. And when the dog smells the person, the reaction is very... Because then the dog goes crazy and runs over to the guy. So they do have that, but I don't know here why these dogs didn't recognize.
Well, there's, 4 of them, and it's kind of like this pack mentality. If one starts going, then they all follow suit, and they start biting until they figure it out. Like, oops.
Yeah. Terrible. Hey, let's get a news update, Chris Little, and then we will finish up Handle on the News. This is KFI AM 640 live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app.
Orange County's COVID-19 number of people in the hospital there has risen to 376. That happened yesterday, 54 more than Tuesday, and the most since September 13th. The number of patients in intensive care rose by 6 to 72. Orange County has slightly more than 20% of its intensive care unit beds available. Former USC running back Anthony Davis is one of three people being inducted into the Rose Bowl Hall of Fame today, 2 days before the 108th Rose Bowl game in Pasadena. And Mayor Bill de Blasio says New York City will ring in 2022 in Times Square as planned, despite record numbers of COVID-19 infections in the city and around the nation. We'll take a look at your drive with the KFI in the Sky next.
A light source whole house water filtration system is all about a very high-end filter. Provides filtered, delicious water from every faucet in your home. That's kind of neat. I mean, you could literally fill up a water bottle from your bathroom, sink, shower with light source. You skip the cost and the hassle of buying water. But here is really where the magic takes place. It filters out the chlorine, added chemicals from your water, reduces your hard water problems and scale buildup, and there's no maintenance of any kind. Once installed, you are done. You're washing your clothes in this water, you're bathing in it, your dishes. Effectively, you're doing all of that with bottled water, quality water. And that's why I love this system. I've had it home for years. No middleman, get factory direct prices. This makes quality water easy. Call 800-334-5009, 800-334-5009. Visit lifesourcewater.com. LifeSource Water, taste and feel the difference.
Don't let rising prices put a damper on your New Year's celebration. Stop by your local grocery outlet and save up to 40 to 70% versus traditional grocery stores. You heard that right. A savings of 40 to 70% only at your neighborhood grocery outlet.
Rain today, highs in mid-50s to around 60, slightly cooler in the valleys in the Inland Empire. This report brought to you by Grocery Outlet. We've got a crash in Pomona on the 10.
It's on the eastbound side of Gary. It has the three right lanes shut down. That's going to be a rough go for your drivers to come away from the 57. You can try for the 60 eastbound as an alternate. It's looking relatively decent. Going to be a bit busy out of Diamond Bar. Off the 57 ahead into Chino towards the 60. And the eastbound side of the 210 as an alternate. And that looks great for you. Off the 57 all the way to Ranch Cucamonga and Alcaloma as you make way toward the 15. I've seen a rough go before your drive due to the wet weather and slick roadways. For the drive along the 605 north and southbound, pretty much a mess for you both directions between the 5 and the 210. So definitely give yourself some extra time getting out the door this morning. 710 north and southbound as an alternate to the 605 north and south. Not any better for you between East LA and Long Beach. KFI in the Sky helps get you there faster. I'm Nick Pagliocchini.
This report is sponsored by ChooseChangeCA.org. Our lives are filled with choices. What's not a choice? Addiction to opioids. But even with opioid use disorder, you still have a choice. Choose treatment and choose change, California. Buy medically proven treatment options at ChooseChangeCA.org.
Why not give your loved ones a healthy air holiday?
This Christmas, show your appreciation by helping them enjoy the healthy benefits of clean air.
IQ air purifiers capture up to 99% of airborne particulates using patented, industry-leading Hyper HEPA filtration technology.
IQ Air's high-efficiency air purifiers filter smoke, pollen, dust, mold, bacteria, and viruses as small as 0.003 microns, the smallest airborne particles that exist.
IQ Air delivers immediate clean air directly to your breathing zone with a portable, award-winning Autumn Series 5-in-1 system.
For the desk, the car, on the go, setup is easy anywhere there's a flat surface.
For the whole home, IQ Air offers the Ultra Quiet Health Pro Plus Series, the number one air purification choice for asthma and allergy sufferers.
Your friends and your family will love the confidence that comes from taking back control over their environment and from breathing clean, filtered air.
Go to iqair.com/US or call 877-778-7324. iqair.com/US or 877-778-7324.
The holiday shopping season is almost here, and small business owners need a plan to get those crucial holiday shoppers through their doors. Be sure your plan includes radio ads from iHeartAdBuilder.com. Radio lets you reach customers wherever they go, at home or in their car. And at iHeartAdBuilder, you can create an affordable custom radio ad on your phone. Just click, listen, approve, then hear it on air. Get ready for the holidays today with a customized ad from iHeartAdBuilder.com.
Hi, Tim Connell here of Connell Chevrolet Costa Mesa. Find your tag, find your deal, and enjoy $500 in red tag bonus cash on select new Chevys at ConnellChevrolet.net. Find new roads at Connell Chevrolet, the Orange County original since 1964.
With school back in session, there's plenty to worry about. CalHope can help with free COVID-19 emotional support. Call 833-317-4673 or live chat at calhope.org today.
Contractor watch this 1047781.
Sometimes when I'm hanging out with my ghetto technicians, they tell me something I never expected.
Really?
Like what? Most of our guys used to work for small companies before they came to work for us.
I can't believe you didn't know that already.
Oh, I knew that. What I didn't know is that most of them were afraid of coming to work for a big company like Ghetto. They were afraid of becoming invisible, you know, like a cog in a machine.
I was afraid, too.
So why did you come, Zach?
I came to Ghetto for the same reason as all them other guys.
I'm on pins and needles.
I came because you don't take shortcuts. Good technicians always want to work for someone who believes in doing things the right way, not the easy way.
I appreciate you saying that, Zach.
And we appreciate you giving us the time to do the job right, even after we've already quoted a price and all them extra hours coming out of your pocket.
If I didn't do things the right way, my dad would slap me on the back of my head, and he was big.
And you ain't never make none of us feel invisible either.
G-O-E-T-T-F.
We'll keep you cool, but it's hard to spell.
If holiday music turns your joy all the way up to 10, then SiriusXM is your home for the holidays. From traditional and country to pop, soul, and so much more, SiriusXM has exclusive holiday channels dedicated to the music that makes your season bright. Listen in the car on the way to the party, or in the living room as you're wrapping presents. Visit SiriusXM.com/listenholiday for how to start listening.
You wouldn't trust a butcher to babysit your pet pig. You wouldn't trust a lumberjack to repair your antiques. Or a professional wrestler to be your massage therapist. So why would you trust anyone but AMCO to fix your car? For over 50 years, we've been the trusted experts in transmission repair. Check engine light on? We'll check it for free. Limited time offer. Restrictions and exclusions apply. See participating centers for full details. AA, NCO.
The music we listen to all year long. The anthems that were our soundtrack for 2021. And the stars who make the songs we love. We'll all be celebrated at our 2022 iHeartRadio Music Awards.
Let's get it started.
Going back to Fox, March 22nd, live from Los Angeles. Get ready for our 2022 iHeartRadio Music Awards.
I'm excited. I'm excited for this baby. I feel like I'm old enough for this baby. I feel like now in my life, like I'm old enough
to appreciate a baby.
She's just going to have like an attachment on her boobs for a while. How long does that last?
It depends on the kids.
Gary and Shannon.
You know, you've seen some
kids
from like 6 years old.
Weekdays at 10 a.m. on KFI.
Radio app, good morning, Bill Handel Show. He's back on Monday. Let's finish up Handel on the news. Me and Chris Little. A tiger has been shot and killed at a zoo in Florida because a worker went into its enclosure who was not supposed to go in there. It was a worker for a cleaning company. Their normal responsibilities are cleaning the restrooms and the gift shop, not the animal enclosures. And they think the guy just decided to go in there either to feed the tiger or pet the tiger. And so why does the tiger have to die?
That was my question. I was going to say, especially since he was shot, or the tiger was shot after attacking the guy. Now, if the tiger was in the middle of attacking the guy and the zoo people said, hey, get out of the way, and the tiger didn't move, then okay, yeah. But why? I don't know why. Do you know why?
Because this is what we do to animals. We put them in prison, and then when they act like animals, we decide they're the bad guys.
It's crazy.
I think that if you're going to have zoos, I certainly think a rule should be there's no liability if somebody goes into an animal enclosure that's not supposed to be in there. You go in and you get eaten by a tiger, too bad. That tiger, just maybe all you do is you don't give the tiger its next meal because it already had one.
And it was an 8-year-old tiger.
It's absurd. Zoos are absurd.
Yeah. So. Riverside, police in Riverside are trying to identify a couple of people who they say swiped some stuff from a pet store, then went back and tossed hot coffee on the employees. Apparently, it was an act of vengeance because they were called out for the theft. That's crazy.
Well, they shoplifted, and then the owner, I think, went, followed them out to the parking lot and said, hey, you take all this stuff, I want it back. And they gave back one thing, and then they kind of left. And they were so salty about being confronted for committing a crime that they came back. Thank God the coffee was not hot enough to actually injure.
Right.
Nobody got scalded, thank goodness. But I would still, if I were the prosecutor, I might try to pull a little assault with a deadly weapon, for starters. And then you'd have to back off, obviously. But this is the level of hubris on the part of these two people. Now, they will find them because they were stupid enough, thank goodness, to first be on video with the original shoplifting.
Sure.
And then they came back again in the same vehicle. So there's two separate, clips of video, surveillance video of these people. They will find them.
Sure.
And this is a real throw the book at them situation because the fall, not just the fall, but the attitude underneath it. How dare you confront me for stealing from you? It's like the case where the guy was trying to steal the car.
Right.
And everybody came out to confront him, and the guy who's wrong, stealing the car, shoots another guy.
Oh, yeah, he died.
Yeah. I mean, it's one thing to be a criminal and not want to get caught, and if people confront you, you run away. That's one level of bad in society,
right.
But the next level of bad is where you feel so entitled to commit crimes that you'll commit extra crimes.
Yeah, they're
and hurt. And hurt people because you're being stopped from committing a lesser crime, like a theft. No good.
That's right.
Nail salon has to pay $1.75 million to a woman for a pedicure gone bad. Now, before you cluck your tongue and say, oh, frivolous lawsuit, it went really bad. They cut the woman's foot. Their instruments were apparently very dirty. The woman got a bad infection and lost her leg.
That's crazy.
So, $1.75 million is not too much.
Yeah.
Or something like that.
Yeah, my wife doesn't like to go to a lot. She goes to one place because she's so afraid of dirty tools.
Well, legitimate, based on this story,
yes.
I would get a buddy of any gender, it doesn't matter, or any gender identity. I would get another person to be manicure pedicure buddy, and we would teach ourselves to do it ourselves and just do it on each other, because then you would know.
Well, you would have
said everything is sterilized.
Well, you would
not have to be afraid.
A non-professional. So you have a non-professional poking around.
Trained.
Okay. Oh, trained.
We watched some YouTube videos. There's plenty of people who know how to do these basic things.
Gotcha. Hey, before we go,
yeah.
I would like to mention that Oprah Winfrey is not going to explicitly endorse Dr. Oz in his campaign for U.S. Senate seat.
Well, she gave him his start. He's only a thing because of her. But maybe because she said, I was behind you when it was medicine, not politics. Or is it because...
Oh, yeah, that's a good point.
Or is it because also in the years since I introduced you to the world, you have come under fire for being a quack?
Well, okay.
Any of those are good reasons to not want to get involved in the political side of it.
Yes, but how does being a quack really translate to being negative in the political world?
That could be an endorsement. Vote for me, I'm a quack.
Exactly.
I fit right in.
I'm like everybody else.
All right, that was Handle on the News. Hey, we'll get a news update from Chris Little, and then Ghislaine Maxwell found guilty. 5 of 6 counts in the sex trafficking trial. What's going to happen to her now? This is KFI AM 640 live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app.
Perfect for aching, indecisive minds. KFI's cooling info gel quickly relieves ignorance and with a blinky breath
sense. KFI.
KOFT-HD2.
Los Angeles, Orange County.
Live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app.
West.
and snowy. I'm Chris Little, live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. The storm system is bringing more rain to Southern California.
It will be an additional 2 to 4 inches for the coast, and then the San Gabriel Valley and the rest of LA County will be 1 to 2 inches of additional rain.
National Weather Service meteorologist Christian Lund says the snow levels have dropped down to 4,500 feet. There are going to be 1 to 3 feet of snow above the 5,000-foot level before the storm moves out. The winter storm warning is in effect until 4 tomorrow morning in the Los Angeles County Mountains, except for the Santa Monica Range. The LAPD officer who accidentally shot and killed a 14-year-old girl at a store in North Hollywood has been identified as William Jones. The LAPD released a video on Monday where Jones can be seen in the store along with other officers who were calling him by his name. Jones shot and killed a man who was attacking customers with a bike lock in the store. They say one of his bullets ricocheted off the floor and hit the 14-year-old girl who was trying on dresses with her mom. Orange County is going to spend $45 million in the new year for homeless resources that include a vaccine reward program.
Now, Optima interim CEO Michael Hunt says 58% of the 870,000 low-income members served by the county health system are vaccinated, but a $25 gift card per shot could improve that number.
That includes their first shot, their second shot, and then their booster.
COO Yoo Young Kim says the funds extend a pilot program that delivers services to homeless people.
To parks, to train stations, to mobile clinics, to homeless shelters.
The funds also extend a recuperative care program that offers services while caring for homeless people who were just released from the hospital. In Orange County, Corbin Carson, KFI News.
Police in Iowa have arrested a man from California during a traffic stop for carrying a rifle and having a hit list for White House officials. The hit list included President Biden and Anthony Fauci. The guy allegedly told cops he was on his way to the White House to kill people in power. Cops found an AR-15 type rifle, ammo, body armor, medical kit, and a hook in the guy's car. The guy's hit list also included former Presidents Clinton and Obama and Meta Chief Executive Mark Zuckerberg. Let's go out to the freeways. It's a mess out there. We got a crash in Santa Clarita on the 5.
That's definitely the case, Chris. On the southbound side before Alliance, the right lane is saying that's going to be a rough ride for you through Valencia as you come away from Machine Park right now. Updating your drive for the 5 northbound. As you're getting out to Safe Junction, leaving the 126 to Newhall Ranch Road, that's passing tight for you all the way to the Grapevine because the Grapevine is shut down 5 north and southbound. Southbound side of things, not looking too crazy bad, although you are stuck if you're making your way from the merge with the 90 heading for the Grapevine. And the northbound side of 5 again, those delays start at the 126 or Newhall Ranch Road. And do stick around all the way into the Grapevine to make way through the Gorman and Lebec area. Got an update of anything slowing down your drive, pound 250 on your cell phone. Keyword is KFI traffic, seeing a rough go for your drive as you're making way through the Estelmar area on the southbound side of 5 before the 210. That's a crash into the carpool lane, take a lane, and back up the drive for you out of the Newhall Pass, leaving the 14. KFI and the sky helps get you there faster. I'm Nick Holly of Phoenix.
Why not give your loved ones a healthy air holiday?
This Christmas, show your appreciation by helping them enjoy the healthy benefits of clean air.
IQ air purifiers capture up to 99% of airborne particulates using patented, industry-leading hyper-HEPA filtration technology.
IQ Air's high-efficiency air purifiers filter smoke, pollen, dust, mold, bacteria, and viruses as small as 0.003 microns, the smallest airborne particles that exist.
IQ Air delivers immediate clean air directly to your breathing zone with a portable, award-winning Autumn Series 5-in-1 system.
For the desk, the car, on the go, setup is easy anywhere there's a flat surface.
For the whole home, IQ Air offers the ultra-quiet Health Pro Plus Series, the number one air purification choice for asthma and allergy sufferers.
Your friends and your family will love the confidence that comes from taking back control over their environment and from breathing clean, filtered air.
Go to iqair.com/US or call 877-778-7324. iqair.com/US or 877-778-7324.
Head here today to the Ford Year-End Sell-A-Thon and get great holiday deals like 0% for 60 months plus $2,500 bonus cash on the 2021 Ford Escape, Edge Explorer, and the rugged Ford Ranger. And don't forget the 2021 Ford F-150. Get it with 0% for 60 months plus $2,500 bonus cash. Hurry, you don't want to miss the Ford Year-End Sell-A-Thon.
Not all buyers qualify for Ford credit 0% APR financing for 60 months at $1,667 per month for $1,000 financing. Example 0% down. Offers valid 12/23 through 1/3/22. See dealer for details.
Southern California weather from KFI, rain today, highs in the mid 50s to around 60. A little bit cooler in the valleys in the Inland Empire than partly cloudy tonight with a chance of showers Friday. Looks like it'll be partly cloudy with highs in the mid-50s to around 60. For New Year's Day, partly cloudy in the morning, then sunny, with highs in the mid-50s to around 60. Right now, Orange 54, Buena Park 53 is 50 in Glendora, 50 in Whittier. We lead local, live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. I'm Chris Ritter. Ringo is the greatest Ringo. You know, Ringo sometimes gets a bad rap for being not the flashiest drummer going. He and Max Weinberg, two guys that kind of... But with Max Weinberg, it's true. Max Weinberg is a metronome. He is excellent, but he is not flashy. And I think part of that is because, I'm surmising, Bruce doesn't want to be upstage too much. Ringo also, people go, yeah, he's all right. He's not, you know, crazy drummer. But man, there are a few Beatles songs where he goes nuts, and it's fantastic. And don't you think for one second that Keith Moon was not influenced by Ringo Starr, particularly in the song. It's Music Soapbox Thursday here on KFI. I'm Wayne Resnick, and I have strong opinions about music, particularly drummers. You want to hear one of the best drummers ever in the history of rock, ever? And don't roll your eyes when I say this. You know the band The Knack? Don't roll your eyes. Oh, The Knack. They thought they were going to be the next Beatles. They were very arrogant and all that. No. That first album by The Knack, called Get The Knack, it is, on its face, straight ahead, 60s-inspired, jangly, power pop, right? Like, in other words, nothing innovative, per se. Sounds like normal music. Listen to the drumming, listen to the bass playing, listen to the guitar solos. These were some of the most accomplished musicians ever, and they all played together in the same band. And I remember, and then we'll get into Gasoline Maxwell was found guilty of sex trafficking. We will get to that. But I just want to tell you, because apparently this whole week I've been confessing all kinds of unflattering things about myself. I recall and will never forget forcing my college dorm roommate, Kevin DeBoard, who I'd gone to high school with. We were friends from high school. We went to college together, shared a dorm room. I bet he regretted that decision because I made him stay up all night to listen to that first Mac album. We had to do a run-through listening to the drumming, another run-through listening to the bass playing. You get the idea. He did go on to marry my ex-girlfriend, so I think it probably equalized. Now, Ghislaine Maxwell was found guilty by that jury, 5 of 6 counts pertaining to sex trafficking in connection to Jeffrey Epstein. They decided to acquit her on one count of enticing a minor to travel for illegal sexual purposes. And that is simply because they were very precise in looking at the law, what had to be proven beyond a reasonable doubt for each of these counts, and they found one of the elements lacking in terms of the government's proof as to one of the counts. Still, you know, a pretty good day for the prosecutors, a terrible day for Glenn Maxwell, and an important day for the bigger picture of this whole enterprise. The whole, I'm Jeffrey Epstein, and I like to get sexual with underage girls, and I have enough money that I can live in a bubble where I can tell myself it's not creepy. and I can get people around me who will normalize this behavior of mine so that I don't have to every day be faced with what a disgusting sex predator that I am. And it's important for that whole enterprise because if you look at who's been held accountable, it's pretty much Ghislaine Maxwell at this point. You know, Epstein killed himself. Or didn't he? If you're a conspiracy theorist. But he certainly was not held to answer in a court of law. So this conviction of Ghislaine Maxwell could be very important in this regard. The prosecutors would have loved Ghislaine Maxwell to become a cooperator early on. Hey, Ghislaine, we're arresting you for all this stuff. Well, I'll tell you what can I do for you? Well, you can tell us about other people who helped all this happen. Oh, I'll be happy to. And then what happens is you end up with a nice plea agreement as a cooperator providing substantial assistance. The government will move for you to get a lower sentence than the law would otherwise provide. And, you know, she might have even been able to come out of this with a relatively short prison sentence. She decided now that she's been convicted, that tactic didn't work. The door is open again.